Hello, this is Ramon for the Thinking Scrubs, and we are here today to do our very first episode for the Faction Breakdown Orientation. So in these episodes, what we want to do is give new players in the X-Wing scene a quick 15-20 minute video to review as one of our more experienced players in this specific in a specific faction talks about what makes their faction good, bad, and what to look at for when if you want to start playing that specific faction. So today, in our first very first episode, we'll be talking about the Scum faction with our guest speaker, Ellie Bitang. Ellie, can you give me a little bit of background on who you are, what you do, and maybe give our readers an idea, our listeners an idea, and viewers an idea, why you're our guest speaker for today for the Scum faction.
All right. So hi, everyone. As Ramon said, I am Ellie. I've been playing X-Wing since the 1.0 version, and I've been playing Scum since the start of version 2.0. I've won a few tournaments using the Scum faction. Actually, all my tournaments I've played, I used the Scum faction, so I've had a lot of, you could say, fly time with the Scum faction.
Yes, and a significant amount of success, definitely.
Yes.
What else do you think about? Is there any like a story behind your choice of the Scum faction, Ellie?
Well, I started playing Scum about. Well, I came back into playing X-Wing tail end of version 1.0. I started playing Scum because I lost a game against a Scum squad used by, you know, your host.
What?
Ramon. Yep.
That's so, the story.
Yeah, so I started playing Scum because he crushed me using Dengar Tweak squad. So I was playing, I was practicing for an upcoming tournament. I was using Rebels. I was playing Dash Rendar and Miranda on the K-Wing. And I got crushed by Dengar and Tweak. So I was like, that's so strong. So right after that gaming session, I went to the store and bought my own Guns for Hire and Jumpmaster that very same day, and that's how I started playing Scum. I've been playing Scum ever since.
I'm honored to be part of that story of how you started playing Scum. I was thinking more along the lines of why you started Scum in 2.0, but
all right. So that's also, there's also a quick explanation for that. So going to 2.0, I thought Scum was the cheapest way to get into the 2.0 version. I only needed a damage deck, a ruler, and one conversion kit. I didn't have to buy the starter set anymore. So I just, you know, I went to Scum, and I've been playing Scum ever since.
Oh, okay. So yeah, let's see if that's still the same case now that we're at least a year into X-Wing 2.0. We're going to be talking about best picks later. But for now, let's move on into giving the Scum faction their background. Ellie, how do you summarize what the Scum faction is?
It's like a hodgepodge. You know, all the mercenaries, the outcasts, the criminal factions, they are all in the Scum faction. Your favorite bounty hunters, Jabba the Hutt, the IG droids are here. So all the, I don't want to say bad guys, because they're not bad. They're just, you know, working, for a living.
Yeah, they can be stick, but they're not necessarily bad.
They're like, you know, the chaotic, neutral kind of guys. They work for whoever gives them, you know, money.
Mm-hmm. So just before we move on to the good and the bad parts of the faction, the summary of good and bad, is there a specific Scum character that's your particular favorite? Like lore-wise or even just in the game?
Definitely in the game. I have a particular fondness for Boba Fett, and right now for Guri. Mm-hmm. Yeah, those two are my favorites right now.
Yeah, Boba Fett in the Fire Spray and Guri in the Star Rider.
Yes, that's correct.
So, is there anything you want to add before we move on to the good and the bad?
Well, if you're into being, you're doing into scummy stuff, your favorite is Boba Fett as well. This is the faction to be.
Yeah. I think some of the other ships that people can expect from the Scum faction include Bosk's YV666. The one that looks like
I personally call it the Devil's Freighter.
Why the Devil's Freighter?
Because it's 666.
Oh, true. Okay. I get it now. I'm sorry. I didn't catch on to that too quickly. Okay, so I guess you could move on to the good and the bad. This is Ellie's summary of what's good and bad about the faction. Ellie, can you give us a rundown of your points for both good and bad?
Well, the first thing off the top of my head is the number of ships for the Scum. So the other factions got separated into, you know, different factions, while the Scum, you know, they stayed the same. So definitely they have the most number of ships right now.
Mm-hmm. I guess this is a holdover from first edition, wherein there were only three factions, and then Scum was getting a lot of ships. And then when the other factions all had combined Resistance and Rebels, for example, for the Rebels, and the Imps had combined FO and Imperials, when 2.0 comes in, all these factions get separated into their own sub-factions, but the Scum ships, they stay the same. So I think the Scum ships are somewhere around 18 ships, right? Correct? Or correct me if I'm wrong, Ellie?
Somewhere around that number. Definitely, they have the most. And I think they will continue to have the most number of ships, just because any Scum ship that will be coming in will be added into the faction. However, the other factions, you know, that you still have to separate them into their own sub factions. Unlike Scum, you know, it's a hodgepodge. Everything that falls into Scum, they should put it in the Scum faction.
Okay. So, Ellie, what about your second point? You mentioned that the Scum have good pilot abilities. In what way are they good?
Good pilot abilities. The Scum pilots, mostly, they have this super, they're like super focused into one thing. For example, let's say Fen Rao is like a super offensive ship. The ship ability and the pilot ability all go toward, you know, the offensive type of a ship. So almost all the Scum factions have this kind of super good pilot ability that, you know, promotes individual pilot. You know, it's like they don't have much synergy with each other, but the pilot abilities, you know, they're like a standalone type. You know, they survive on their own, they can win on their own. Those are the kind of pilot abilities that you'll find in the Scum faction.
Yeah, they're very much very hyper-focused. Like Fen Rao is a really a beast at range one. That's the closest range that you can get fighting and shooting other ships. So he's really I would say he's a knife fighter, he's a brawler.
Something like that.
Yeah, and then you've got stuff like Bosk himself generating more hits when he spends crits.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want overwhelming damage, a lot of Scum ships have that, and they do have their tricks. We could segue into the third point by me pointing out one of the best tricks in the Scum faction right now is Captain Seavor.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll let you expound on that.
Well, Scum faction has always been known for the tricks. I guess it's part of being, you know, they're not, lore-wise, they're not, their resources are not as good as the other factions.
Mm-hmm.
And their ships are mostly, you know, scavenged ships or stolen ships, customized ships. So they make up for, they make up for that using, you know, unconventional tricks. In the game, you often see them, you know, launching. Well, there's in 1.0 they had something like EMP device. In 2.0, I guess the scummiest thing would be stealing tokens and giving you stress. Those kind of stuff. Those are just some things you will not find in other factions, and some of them actually they go against, you know, the basic abilities from the game. Some of them, you know, they're kind of very unique
of the game, like outside of faction shooting or tokens and changing costs of tokens.
Yeah, shooting your own ships, that mm-hmm. kind of stuff.
Very interesting. So if you like weird interactions in the game, I guess summarizing that, if you like weird interactions in a faction, Scum is a great faction for you.
Mm-hmm.
But you mentioned here that the Scum faction has low synergy. I mean, they have tricks. What do you mean by low synergy?
Unlike the other faction, for example, Rebels, they have abilities that work off each other, benefit the whole team, the whole squad, mm-hmm. help the other ship. In Scum, it'll be really hard to find anything like that. Almost all abilities benefit. Almost all pilot abilities benefit their own ship. They rarely help their squad mates. Some of them even, you know, give damage to their own teammates so they can benefit from it. Those kind of stuff. They don't really want to work together.
Yeah.
But they're strong on their own.
So, yeah, when you're mentioning that, I can think of only two pilots that buff other teammates. That would be Drea, who buffs generics shooting. Little bit in her firing arc, and then there's Serisu, who lets friendly ships within a close proximity like get a better defense. And then when you mentioned that part about some other pilots being selfish and then using their own teammates for their own gain, I can think of Prince Caesar.
Yeah. And also the Z95 unit. There's the Z95 that steals tokens from teammates.
Oh, I don't remember. Is it Cato Vichos?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, and then it's because of this, how would you say this? And even if that's low synergy, they're still highly effective as on their own, right? So is this the reason why their ships are usually highly costed?
I think most of the ships for the Scum are highly costed because of, you know, the good pilot abilities. Because
mm-hmm.
some of the pilot abilities are so good, if you give them, if they have low cost, they're gonna be too easy to, you know, include in your squad.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, some like Fen Rao, look at him. I mean, if you put him at, you know, something like 50s, 56, like the other, you know, other faction aces.
Yeah.
And I think he's gonna be, you know, too much.
Yeah, that's a lot for Fenrir, for a guy who never, whose death at range one is improbable. Yeah, that's a little too.
Yeah,
that was my opinion, but definitely for someone who takes at least 12 to 14 hits to kill at range one, that 50 is a pretty cheap, and I think 68 is a good price point. But I don't think we're here to debate price points at the moment, no.
Yeah, that's for another episode.
Yes, that's for another episode. Okay, so high costed ships. So that means you were looking at a really low ship count, usually for squads.
Usually you see three, but there's also a lot of, you know, scum squads looking to, you know, use numbers instead. Mm-hmm. But they will be using mostly generics instead of the aces.
Mm. Just for a recent example, I guess in the international stage, it was it Matt Carey or Mike in Gen Con the past?
I think it was Matt.
Yeah, so Matt brought the Cartel Marauder mini swarm with Sivor and Pale of Godali.
It's Turtle Mux.
Oh, Turtle Mux, I'm sorry. So bringing down the initiative of enemy ships and making sure the swarm shoots first. It's a very interesting squad, and I think it's something that can be pretty competitive, and it might be something that might interest some people who are looking for around five ships in a squad.
Yeah.
What do you mean by awkward ships and pilot abilities, though?
All right, so you know, most ships you will find in X-Wing have, let's say, it's just for example, most ships have symmetrical dials,
mm-hmm.
right? But there is this ship in Scum, the Jumpmaster 5000. Mm-hmm. It has, the dial has different, difficulty.
Oh yeah.
Depending on which side you're going to, left or right.
Mm-hmm.
So that definitely makes it awkward.
Because also, it's harder to turn on to the right because it's a very hard difficulty maneuver.
Yeah. We also have the most awkward looking ships.
Are you talking about the Kimogila?
Yeah, the Kimogila is one super ugly ship. also awkward pilot abilities. Moralo Eval, for one. He's the only ship that can go flying off the board, come back the next round. Some of the abilities you really have to, you know, find a way to make them work.
They have a very specific use.
Yeah. I mean, if they work, they're fantastic. But most of the time, you don't know where or when to use them.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see. Since, like, Torkomox, we mentioned him a while ago. I think Torkomox is a ship that you have to build around for it to shine, like this, you know, this that the squad you mentioned with the three Marauders and Seaver.
Yep. So, just to mention to viewers, if you're not familiar, Turtle Mux is a pilot in the Hawk 290, the Scum Hawk 290, whose ability specifically turns initiative of enemies in his fighting arc. Is it a target enemy or all enemies? It's a target enemy.
Just one enemy.
Yep. So it turns a target enemy's initiative to zero. So basically, this guy shoots last during the engagement phase. So it's a pretty strong ability for Torkel. You go ahead, Ellie.
So yeah, mostly, you know, awkward ships, awkward looking ships, awkward pilot abilities. If you're coming from another faction, you know, transferring into the Scum faction, there might be a possibility you'll you'll have to adjust because of this awkwardness in the Scum faction.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, before we move on to the next slide, sorry I moved to that, but basically, the bad points are that it just that the Scum faction doesn't play as your usual faction of what you expect flying around the board.
Yeah, I think among the seven factions, the Scum faction is, you know, the odd one out.
Even more so than the CIS, the droid faction?
Well, the CIS right now are mostly, you know, they're into the swarm and they work pretty well together. Mm-hmm. You see that in the most other factions as well. So I don't think they're really into that awkward spot yet, but they might be, you know, in the near future.
No, yeah, especially with the Nantex getting introduced into the CIS.
That's true. They get the, you know, they're starting to get the scummy feeling.
Mm-hmm. Tricks, all these abilities that make things happen. Okay, so moving on from the strengths and weaknesses of the Scum faction, the uniqueness of the Scum faction paired with its, non-stereotypical gameplay, game styles, can you give us an idea why people should pick this faction? I mean, if you're starting out, you're putting up your budget, you're making, you're looking for your priority list of what you want to buy.
Right now, if you wanna, you know, save a bit when you're getting into the game, I think the Scum faction is still the cheapest way to get into the game.
Mm-hmm.
If you somehow find a way to get a damage deck without buying the starter kit, mm-hmm. you're good, because you can get templates from third party sources.
Yeah, there's actually even a FFG official templates that you can buy.
Yes, that's correct. And well, in the future there will be separate damage decks for sale, but for right now you need to find yourself a damage deck in conversion kit or in some old Scum ships, you're good to go.
Yeah, and if you're playing cash flow, you could borrow a damage deck for a while, and then if you're gonna go to a tournament, you could ask the community if someone could lend you an extra damage deck until maybe the actual FFG official individual damage decks come out, and then maybe grab one of those, right?
Mm-hmm, correct. So also, you know, if you like flying aces, you know, you like playing with the unique characters rather than, you know, the Cartel Marauder or whatnot. You know, this faction has the most aces right now. Also have the most variety in aces and ace abilities.
If it's a replay, what do you mean by aces? What's
aces are, you know, mostly aces are the pilots with the abilities. I think that's the simplest way to describe aces.
Mm-hmm.
Right? They're the unique pilots. They're mostly aces are the I6s, the I5s.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is the faction for you if that's your thing. Although, you know,
like high initiative play, basically.
Yeah, also, right now, Scum is the only faction with three I6s, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, it's going to be matched by the First Order during the next wave, Wave 6. First Order will be able to field three Initiative 6s and possibly Initiative 7. We don't know yet because we don't have the points for the newest Initiative 6. But currently, you could still run Han Solo, Dengar, and Fenrau in one list.
Yeah, you could.
So it's an interesting, if you want that kind of a game style, that high initiative game style. They're not necessarily the double repositioning aces, I guess, but they're high initiative. They have abilities that make them stand out when they're going one-on-one against other ships. Yeah.
And yeah, yep. Also, you know, some people, they just like, you know, doing tricks, you know, doing the dirty tactics in a game.
Oh, in gamer slang, you're talking about control mechanics.
Yeah, kind of, yeah, control. Some of them just doesn't have to be control, but, you know, some people just like, you know, doing the fun stuff. Or being, you know, the D's. Can I say that here? Like being, you know.
Let's keep it the PG-13.
Yeah, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
They like doing stuff their opponent wouldn't want them to do.
Oh, basically surprising their opponents and then confusing them with a rules interaction that's very valid.
Yeah, that's what Scum people do.
Yeah, so, it's underhanded approaches towards game styles, but totally within the rules. But also sometimes a source of headaches when it comes to rules interpretations.
Well, this is, if you want to annoy the hell out of your opponent, Scum is for you.
Yeah. And what do you mean by when you hate flying in formation? Because as we mentioned earlier, there are some swarm archetypes within the Scum faction. Aside from the Cartel Marauders, which is a mini swarm, there's also the Mining Guild Ties, the M3A Interceptors. You can put 5, 6, or maybe even 7 of them in the list. What do you mean by if you hate flying in formation, pick Scum?
Well, there are, of course, there are going to be squads that like, you know, flying in formation because they are swarm.
Mm-hmm.
But those squads, you'd find few of them being used by Scum players. If you're playing Scum, mostly you're going to be playing the Fang Fighters, like Fenrao, the Fire Sprays. You're going to be playing the named pilots. And the named pilots for Scum, they like to fly on their own.
Yeah, and they're pretty expensive too, right?
They don't want to be leashed with, you know, their other squad mates.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them even have abilities that don't work when they're near their squad mates.
Oh, are you talking about Andrew Sulak?
Yeah. Yeah, for the Z95.
For the Z95, who has a built-in lone wolf ability that lets him shoot more red dice.
Yeah, if there is no squadmate within range 1 to 2 of him.
Yes. Also, just I want to point out though that, for example, Drea Swarms are a thing, but they don't fly in a, how to say this, a typical formation. It's basically the use of Drea in a Y-Wing and then getting her ability to cover a group of other ships that are very efficient, very cheap for what they do. There were squad jumpers, and then there were skirt bombers with turrets, but they don't fly like TIE Fighter Swarms, whatever else swarms that we have in the other factions.
Well, that's why, if you hate flying in formation, I think Scum is for you. And, you know, some people, they don't want to bother with, you know, flying in boxed formation of 8 ships. It also, if you're playing a long tournament, a big tournament, you know, flying 8 ships will tire you. You know, maybe around round 3, you're going to be so tired you won't even be. You're not going to be able to play well as you did in the first round.
That's definitely a consideration if you're a new player and you're thinking about getting competitive in the future. So, yeah, these are nice points for anyone starting out. So, if you're starting out, what are great ships to start with? These are your picks,
well,
right? For out of the 16, 17, 18 ships of the Scum faction. You have 4.
Well, I picked these ships because I think these are the ones that are gonna let new players feel what the Scum faction is about. So, for example, the Fang Fighters, the hyper-focused you know, offensive ships. Mm-hmm. That, you know, they trade offense for health. They have four hull. They can be, you know, one shot. They can be killed in one shot, but they can also kill in one shot. So, super offensive ships.
And if you're in, if you're at range one, like really close, like usually some ships prefer to be far away from their opponents to try to survive, right? Engaging at range three, exiting. Firefighters are like, if you're in range one, you always have the upper hand.
Yeah, if you're in range one of a Fang Fighter, bad things are gonna happen.
Yeah. Just shooting styles. It's a very scum thing.
Yeah. Also, moving on to the Mist Hunter. In particular, I chose Forlom.
Mm-hmm.
Because this lets the new player experience the control aspect that the Scum faction has. Well, Forlom gives away a stress token to a ship in range one at the start of the end phase. So stress token is gonna help you control the maneuver of the opposing ship for the next round. So yeah, scummy things.
And I just realized now that the G1A Starfighter has the white jam.
It does.
Interesting. Definitely also one of the rising stars of the start of 2.0, right? Forlom in the Mist Hunter.
I think he was the one of the most used ships for the Scum in the start of version 2.0.
Yeah. Unfortunately, the Mist Hunter is pretty hard to look for right now, right? If you do find one, as long as it's not yet re-released, if you do find one, it's a good find, then you should probably get it, right?
Yeah. Well, basically, it's gonna be hard to find ships that haven't been relaunched.
Yeah, so it's one of those ships. Yeah, so you need the conversion kit and you need the old model from 1.0. So, players looking at the Mist Hunter, beware, think about it before you get it. But if you're committed to getting it, get it. Like, really get it. So it's pretty a solid piece.
Mm-hmm. Moving on, we have the Fire Spray. I chose two pilots from using the Fire Spray. First, Boba Fett, just for, you know, the really, really good pilot ability on Boba Fett. Boba Fett likes to dive in, you know, get up close and trigger his abilities. For Iman, well, you know, scummy things. You know, he gets to drop a bomb using the speed 3 templates, either the straight or the hard turn templates. So, you know, it's just stuff that, you know, goes away from the basic, rules of the game. Instead of, you know, dropping a bomb using the range one, you get to do it, you know, sideways, or you get to drop it farther away from you. Next up is the Starfighters.
Before we talk about the Starfighters, I just want to emphasize the Fire Spray and the Fang Fighters. These were re-released in Wave 1, so if you check your local gaming stores, they probably have the second edition versions of these ships, so they're a little more easier to find.
Yeah, true. And I think there's a lot of these two in stock.
In the Philippines, even.
Yeah. Next up, Star Vipers, another ship that has not been relaunched in the 2.0 version. Main reason why I put this here. I chose the Star Vipers are for the unique barrels that, you know, the ship ability provides. So instead of doing the normal barrels with the one straight template, you get to do it with the back templates. So, you know, you can get, I mean, this, it, you can put your ships in very, you know, well, they can get into positions that are hard to visualize for your opponents.
Yeah, and no other ship can do.
Yeah, and if you put the advanced sensors on them, they're really ships that are hard to catch.
Yeah.
So I should put all the scummy stuff. I chose all the ships with the, you know, scummy abilities to let the, you know, the new player feel what the scum faction is about.
A very interesting selection, and definitely I think it reflects your very aggressive style. Everyone has free attack dice. Everyone is at range one.
Well, because most of the ships are, you can fit them in like a squad of three, maximum four. So you really need the offense to make up for the low number of ships.
Yeah. Oh, just a little caveat for Star Vipers. Since they're like the Mist Hunter, they have yet to be re-released, you still have to look for the 1.0 model and then get the conversion kit. But with Star Vipers, there's a special consideration for these things, because a lot of players back in 1.0 actually brought a lot of models just to get a specific card from 1.0 that was required for Ace Play, which was Auto Thrusters. So, if you're interested in looking for Star Vipers, there's probably someone out there in the community who has extras.
Yeah. Right. Most people bought one just for the card and never played with it.
Yeah.
Well, so, until about the tail end of 1.0, when they got better.
When came in. The creep already came in the Guns for Hire box before, so... that's if you want the alternate looking Star Vipers. Yes, Star Vipers are a pretty good thing on the table, and they give you this different experience about Ace Play, like high initiative Ace Play, especially with Guri, who is a android, the android bodyguard of Prince Sizor, but gets a free focus at range 0-1. A puzzling opponent to fly around with. So definitely fun to fly against and also fly. So Ellie, with this overall, do you have any final words for new Scum players or interested players who are thinking about Scum?
Well, if you're a new player and you want to be in the cool and fun faction, have to use the Scum.
Good propaganda, Ellie. Okay, just a few caveats for some honorable mentions, I guess. Personal favorites that I hope that are making it into the competitive scene. There's the Shadowcaster. Mm-hmm. Shadowcaster is making it great, so if you could look that up if you're interested, with Tractor functions. Also, the Y-Wing is a great Scum workhorse. They have Greya and you have Cavil. They're pretty cheap and do some damage.
Well, the Y-Wing is, you know, a ship you'll find in about half
the captains. Yeah, you've got the Rebel Y-Wing, and then there's the New Republic Y-Wing. It's actually easy if you're thinking about cross-pollinating, I guess, into another faction, into Rebels, for example.
Yeah. Also, if you're a fan of a couple of the latest movies and series of the Star Wars franchise, Mm-hmm. You're gonna find the ships here. You're gonna Lando's Millennium Falcon, the blue one with escape craft.
Oh yeah, Lando's Millennium Falcon. Uh-huh.
I bet a lot of the ships in the upcoming The Mandalorian will be here in the Scum faction.
Oh, that would be exciting.
Right, right. So if you're a fan of those ships are here. So yeah, see you in the Scum faction.
Yeah, if you're not fighting for freedom,
might as well fight for money.
just a day in the life of a businessman.
Yep.
Ellie, thank you so much for doing this thing with us, and I hope our viewers have picked up a good amount of information to get them excited about playing Scum.
I hope so too, and I hope to see them on the tables.
Yes, see you on the tables, viewers. And we're the Thinking Scrubs, and we're signing off.